My name is Paul Heroux. I live in Attleboro. I'm the mayor of Attleboro. I'm 45 years old, but I'll be turning 46 years old this year. I'm running for sheriff because we need change in the Bristol County Sheriff's Office. We should have a jail system that is a modern jail system, a system that is accountable to the taxpayers, and a system that actually reforms people, not just talks about it. We need a sheriff who's going to run a modern jail system. We need a sheriff who's going to really focus on rehabilitation, really think about decreasing recidivism, and really working in the best interests of the people of Bristol County. Felt really compelled to get into this race. I feel like we can do a lot better. I have experience working in a jail. I worked in a prison, and I've also got management experience as the mayor of Attleboro, so I'm quite well qualified. Mura was a Japanese breed. She did everything with me. You know, Mura basically, she knocked on doors with me. She would go and walk in parades with me. One day in 2018, she suddenly passed out. So immediately I rushed her to the her vet. So the blood cancer basically was killing her. In late October, I decided that I'm gonna take a vacation. I decided to go with Mura to Vancouver Island, where she was born. Along the way, every time we went into a new state, or every time we went into a new new national monument of some sort, I took a picture with Mura, and then in November, I got Sashi. Yeah, she loves people. Well, the ICE detention facility, we have to find out what we can do with that, what we're legally allowed to do with that. Right now, Ash Street is being used. It's certainly an outdated facility. We also have the regular House of Correction in Dartmouth. That population is well over its design capacity. And so a lot of people have talked about, hey, maybe we can close down Ash Street. But, you know, that's very popular for people to say. But if we take those people and just those inmates and put them in Dartmouth, then what's going to happen is you're going to have even a worse overcrowding situation. When we try to close down a facility, we have to put those inmates somewhere. The sheriff doesn't have the legal authority to just release somebody to the street. The sheriff doesn't get to say, no, we're not going to take this person, or I'm going to release this person early. So sheriff, you know, that's done by the courts, and the job of the sheriff is to hold those people. So if we were to close Ash Street, we have to put those inmates somewhere. And right now, if we were to put them in Dartmouth, we would exacerbate the overcrowding situation in Dartmouth. So we have to make sure we're not going to try to solve one problem and make another problem even worse. So one of the other concerns about what's going on in Bristol County jail system is the high level of suicides. And suicide, you know, from my understanding of suicide, and I have a bachelor's in psychology, but my understanding of suicide is it's not that people want to die. It's not that they want to kill themselves. It's that they are hopeless that things are not going to change. And so if you have an atmosphere where you have a higher than average level of suicide, that's basically a signal, a real red flag, that it's hopeless. Things are not going to get better. So I would do things different. You have to focus on discharge planning, setting people up for success when they're being released. You have to focus on making sure they have housing, making sure they have health care, which includes drug treatment and mental health, making sure that they have a job. If they don't have a job, getting them the skills training for a job, workforce development, making sure they have something as basic as an ID. When they're being released back into society, they have hope that they have a chance. But now you can still hold people accountable and still run a correctional facility, you know, without the civil rights violations and with, you know, doing it properly, you know, with rehabilitation. I felt compelled to get into this race because none of these things are being done. We don't have a modern jail system. We have a jail system where, you know, the current sheriff, the incumbent, basically says, you know, I'm going to make your life miserable, and if you don't like it, don't come back. For people who have mental health issues or drug addiction issues, that's not an effective strategy to reduce recidivism. The way things are currently being done at the Bristol County Sheriff's Office is not a best practice. It's not in the best interest of the people of the county.